I think it's a question of time frame. Mm-hmm. So your first question is, what is the purpose of us trying to, quote, do good while making a buck? And if it's a quarter-to-quarter view and you're a short-term investor, the argument is arguably harder, especially if you have a longer ROI. Luckily, most of us are in business for the long run. We've built things. We want to establish reputations. The top Fortune 50 companies have been around for 100 years. That's what CEOs envision. So we have the opportunity here to fight short-termism and really sell up the food chain to boards, to investors, that sustainability is another word for long-term smart investment.
And what's been your experience at JetBlue? Has it been a struggle to convince, you know, your bosses and your boards that this is the long-term view is the view they should be taking?
We're a publicly listed company, so we have quarter-to-quarter calls, and I think that answers the question to a certain extent. The more social pressure there is and the more expectations there are from consumers to behave in a certain way, the more it helps folks like me make a long-term argument without necessarily waiting for the regulation and needing to rely on the fear of regulations, carrot and stick.
I don't think there's any question that there's a responsibility to the private sector. And it is good business. And it is important to take a long view. Now, that's easy for me to say because I'm in the private sector. When we first took a look at Babcock Ranch, it was a 91,000-acre ranch. That's 143 square miles. And we sold 73,000 acres to the state of Florida and Lee County, and the largest land purchase in the history of the state. And then we ended up with 18,000 acres. And out of that 18,000 acres, we're preserving half of that. So at the end of the day, 90% of the original ranch, Babcock Ranch, is in preservation forever. And that's a legacy that's going to be that people are going to be able to enjoy for generations. And we think that's very, very important. And then we ended up with this basically 9,000 acres, and we're building a new town, but a very sustainable town. And we think it's good business. So when we started planning our new town, we went back 40 years and looked at plans to see how the natural flowways through this property kind of worked their way through, and that's how we designed it. And we designed it on land that has already been disturbed. And so when you think about what you can do from the private sector and make it profitable, we believe it's great business, mm-hmm. A, but B, it's the right thing to do. We have issues that we have to address as a society, and we think it's our responsibility to do that. So it's very exciting to us. And one of the things that we talked about, the first solar town, one of our first initiatives was say, how do we deal with the energy? You know, we're going to have almost 20,000 homes and 6 million people. 6 million square feet of commercial space.
Say that's a lot of people.
I was going to say, that's more like a China city.
Right,
but it's going to be about 50,000 people. But energy was the key for us. So we spent almost nine years of time. We actually made the announcement here in Washington, D.C. that we're going to become the first solar-powered town in America. And Florida Power & Light has built a 75-megawatt solar power generating facility right on our property. It's there today. We donated the 440 acres. They've installed 343,000 panels. So when you're at Babcock Ranch today and you look at the light in our town, it's powered by solar energy. And at night, natural gas then kicks in, and it's powered by natural gas. So the combination of those two make it the cleanest form of energy of anywhere in the country. But the next step is storage. So how do we take this to a whole other level? And if we can store the energy and not be on the grid, then we've really, really accomplished something. And that's where we're headed towards. But that's good business. And I'll just one quick story. We had an event where we said, come see our progress at Babcock Ranch. And because everything was under construction and people wanted to see what was going on there. And we're hoping a couple thousand people would show up. That's a lot of people, a couple thousand people coming in to see what you're doing. Well, 20,000 people came to see what was going on at Babcock Ranch. And every single person there was asking, we want to see the solar. We want to see what's going on with the solar. So Florida Power & Light has agreed to build an observatory so people can actually see the scale.
They want to see the plant itself.
They wanted to see what it was all about and how it actually worked. And they were very and so Florida Power & Light has put a kiosk in to explain how it works. And then they're going to have an observation tower so people can actually see really what the scale of what they're doing.
Huh. I think what this conversation has already shown is that sustainability might have been leading edge 20 years ago. Mm-hmm. It's pretty mainstream today. Yeah. It has been embraced by corporate America. In fact, 71% of Fortune 100 companies have specific numeric renewable or greenhouse gas targets that they've committed to achieve. They're accountable to their board and shareholders to achieve that. When you go to the Fortune 500, it's over 43% and growing. So this is already pretty mainstream with the large companies. I think it's growing down to even the smaller size companies. Agreed. And when you look at the size of the advanced energy industry, the clean tech industry that powers our economy, this is not a future industry. This is a current big business. We're a $200 billion U.S. industry, over 3 million jobs, roughly the size of retail, and growing three times faster than the U.S. economy when you don't count ethanol. Mm-hmm. So this is a fast-growing, already existing industry, which just underscores that sustainability is now mainstream in at least corporate America.
And just to be clear, the advanced energy economy is?
So we're all forms of kind of cutting-edge advanced technology. So it's the renewable guys, wind, solar, energy efficiency, electric vehicles, fast-acting natural gas, modular nuclear reactors, all the forms of technologies that may not have been competitive 20 years ago, but are competitive and being deployed today.
And are you